हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू साइंस क्लास। एज यू नो अवर रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट लेसन इज ओवर। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो आई एम एक्सप्लेन टेक्स्ट बुक एक्सरसाइज एंड आफ्टर दिस वीडियो होपफुली आई विल सेंड यू अ PDF ऑफ दिस लेसन। फ्रॉम दिस यू कैन राइट आंसर्स इन योर CW। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। नंबर वन, प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यू इंडिविजुअल्स फ्रॉम द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट ऑफ पेरेंट इज कॉल्ड डैश। सी दिस, योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स एंड हियर आर द आंसर्स। प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यू इंडिविजुअल्स फ्रॉम द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट ऑफ पेरेंट इज कॉल्ड वेजिटेटिव प्रोपोगेशन। सेकेंड, a flower may have either male or female reproductive parts, such a flower is called dash, unisexual flowers। You know that two types of flowers are there, bisexuals and unisexuals। A flower may have either male or female reproductive part, it means only one type of part, either male or female, so this type of flower is called unisexual flowers। Number three, the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the same or of another flower of the same kind is known as pollination। It means, as you know that the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma, this is called pollination। And number four, the fusion of male and female gamete is termed as fertilization। Number five, seed dispersal takes place by means of wind, water and animals, it means that agent of dispersal of seeds, wind, water and animals। Question number two, describe the different methods of asexual reproduction, give examples। So you know that different method of asexual reproduction, vegetative propagation, budding, fragmentation, this all। Now shortly we'll describe these methods। First, vegetative propagation, it is the ability of a plant to produce new plants from roots, stems, leaves and buds। Vegetative propagation is divided into again two types। See, where vegetative propagation means that reproduction by the vegetative parts of a plant, and what are the vegetative parts of the plant? Roots, stem, leaves and buds। So that vegetative propagation means it is the ability of a plant to produce new plants from roots, stem, leaves and buds, and vegetative propagation is divided again into two types। Second is budding, it involves the formation of a new individual from a bulb like projection called a bud। The bud grows and gets detached from the parent to form a new individual, it is commonly observed in yeast। As you remember, I gave you an example of yeast in budding। So budding, it involves the formation of a new individual from a bud-like projection called a bud, and the bud grows and gets detached from the parent to form a new individual, it is commonly observed in yeast। Third is fragmentation, it is a form of asexual reproduction where a new organism is formed from the fragments of a parent body, it is the only mode of asexual reproduction in Spirogyra। And here also I gave you one example of Spirogyra। Now question number three, explain what you understand by sexual reproduction। So here you have to explain what you understand by sexual reproduction। So sexual reproduction is a process which involves production of seeds, it requires two parents। Most plants reproduce sexually with the help of flowers, The main function of a flower is to reproduce and therefore develop new seeds that can grow into new plants. Means in sexual reproduction, seeds are necessary. So sexual reproduction is a process which involves production of seeds. So here seeds are necessary. So here also involve production of seeds. And in sexual reproduction, two parents are required, compulsory. And you know that flowers are the reproductive part of a plant. So most plants reproduce sexually with the help of flowers. And the main function of a flower is to reproduce and therefore develop new seeds that can grow into new plants. Question number 4. State the main differences between asexual and sexual reproduction. Two methods of reproduction, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. So here two columns are there, one for asexual reproduction and second for sexual reproduction. Number first point, for asexual reproduction, only one parent plant is involved. In asexual reproduction, only one parent plant is involved, and in sexual reproduction, both male and female parents are involved. Second point, asexual reproduction occurs in unisexual plant, and sexual reproduction occurs in bisexual plant. Third point, for asexual reproduction occurs in lower plants. Third point, for sexual reproduction occurs in higher plants. Fourth point, for asexual reproduction, reproductive organs are not present. And in sexual reproduction, fully developed reproductive parts are present. Fifth point, for asexual reproduction, in most of the methods, the original parent disappears. And in sexual reproduction, original parents remains alive after process of reproduction. Next point, for asexual reproduction, process like gamete formation or fertilization is not seen. And for sexual reproduction, fertilization or gametes give rise to zygote. Next point, for asexual reproduction, characteristics of only one parent is inherited. And for sexual reproduction, characteristics of both parents are inherited. Next point, for asexual reproduction, no need of seed. And for sexual reproduction, seeds are used to get new plants from a flower. So here total 8 points are given for difference between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So according to marks, you will write that points. For example, it is in exam 2 marks questions given. So you will write only 2 points for each. If it is given for 3 marks, so you will write 3 points for each. Here 8 points are given. Among them, any 3 or 4 you can learn. Now question number 5, sketch the reproductive parts of a flower. Here you have to sketch that reproductive part of the flower. You know that reproductive part of a flower, two reproductive part, that stamen and pistil. One is male and one is female. So stamen is the male reproductive part of the flower and pistil is the female reproductive part of a flower. Here first picture is of stamen. Again you will draw these two part, filament and anther. Now in pistil, again stigma, style, ovary, ovule. Question 6, explain the difference between self-pollination and cross-pollination. Here one more difference between self-pollination and cross-pollination. Again you will make two columns, one for self-pollination and one for cross-pollination. First point, for self-pollination, pollen grains are transferred to the stigma of the same flower. And first point for cross pollination, pollen grains are carried to stigma of another flower. Second point for self-pollination occurs in bisexual plants having anther and stigma maturing at same time. Second point for cross-pollination occurs in bisexual flowers having anther and stigma maturing at different times. Third point for self-pollination, it takes place in plants like wheat, peas, etc. And third point for cross-pollination, it takes place in plants like lady's finger, tomato, brinjal, etc. Here also 3 points are given. According to marks, you will write answer. Again, same. If this question is given of 2 marks, you will write only 2 points for each M. And if that question is given for 3 marks, so you will write 3 points of each. Question number 7. How does the process of fertilization take place in flowers? Answer. When the pollen grains reaches the stigma of a same species flower, it starts growing out into the pollen tube and a pollen tube of the stigma. This tube continues to grow inside the style till it reaches the ovule. Male cells are released into the ovule for the fertilization with the female egg cells, and thus the zygote is formed. After this process of fertilization, the ovary develops into fruit and ovule into seeds. So this is the process of fertilization. It means when pollen grain reaches the stigma of the flower, now it start growing into that pollen tube, and it continues to go. It means it reaches to the ovary of the pistil. Now after that, in ovary it reaches to the ovule, which are the female cells. Now these male cells male cells of the pollen grain fuses with the female egg cells, fertilize, and zygote is formed. And after this process, what will happen? The ovary develops into fruit and ovule into seeds. So this is the process of fertilization. So how does the process of fertilization take place in flower? When the pollen grain reaches the stigma of a same species flower, it starts growing out into the pollen tube of the stigma. This tube continues to grow inside the style till it reaches the ovule. Male cells are released into the ovule for the fertilization with the female egg cell, and thus the zygote is formed. After this process of fertilization, the ovary develops into fruit and ovule into seeds. Question number 8. Describe the various ways by which seeds are dispersed. You know how seeds are dispersed. How many methods are there? So following are the ways in which the seeds are dispersed. Some seeds are light, some are hairy seeds, some dry seeds, some heavy seeds. So different types of seeds are there. Spiny seeds are there, so they disperse in different ways. First is some light seeds like that of madar, which are hairy, dry and small, are carried away by the wind to different places. It means dispersal by the wind. Second, spiny seeds and fruits like that of xanthium and urena stick to the clothes of passers by and animals, and these seeds are carried away by this agent to different places. It means dispersed by animals. In some plants having heavy seeds like that of coconut, water acts as a dispersing agent. So here dispersed by water. And some seeds are dispersed with the fruit burst, like in case of balsam and castor. So this food bursting. Question number 9. Match the items in column 1 with those in column 2. See, here again two columns are given. First is bird. So bird you will join with yeast. You will find this process of reproduction in yeast. Then eyes, you will find eyes on potatoes. Fragmentation, the example of fragmentation, Spirogyra. Wings, which seeds have wings? Maple. Now spores, here bread, mold. Question number 10. Tick, write the correct answer. Here for each question, four options are given. From these options, you will write correct option. First, the reproductive part of a plant is the reproductive part of a plant is, the options are leaf, stem, root and flower. And the correct option is flower. Question 2. The process of fission of the male and the female gamete is called. The fission of male and female gamete is called. And the options are fertilization, pollination, reproduction and seed formation. And the correct option is fertilization. Number 3. Mature ovary forms the and the options are seed, stamen, pistil and fruit. Here your correct option is fruit. Next, a spore producing plant is and the options are rose, bread mold, potato, ginger. And the correct option is bread mold. Spore formation, bread mold. In on bread mold spores you can see. Next is bryophyllum can be reproduced by its and the options are stem, leaves, roots, flowers. And the correct option is leaves. So students, here textbook exercise of lesson 12 reproduction in plants is over. So I will send you a PDF. Hopefully from this you can write answers in your CW. We'll meet you soon with next lesson. Till then, go through the video twice for better understanding.